Okay, Elk, I don't think we're looking too far down the pack for yours, but let's go with it. Give it to us and we can tear it apart.
Well, this is a very top-heavy field, of course, this week, Diane, being that all the top players that we know of are up top. But picture this, okay? Work with me here. If there's not a big storm that comes in Sunday, let's say we're going to have good weather, no typhoon, we've got all the guys at the top. Morikawa's up there, Matsuyama, you know, Justin Thomas, Hovland, they're all at the top of the field. But wait, here comes in the pack, like Ledecky last night, who had the lead, Tightmas, our 200-meter freestyle swimming girl, tracked her down at the end, and here comes Cam Smith, takes his hat off with a couple holes left. He's got the Oz cut into the side of his head, and he's going to blitz through the field on the back nine with the number one putter and just take over the Olympic golf. Go, Aussie!
I don't know whether to be offended or flattered that you have picked my bronze medalist, i.e. the top, and you're making him a dark horse. There's no way that he is a dark horse.
He's a late runner. He's coming in late.
Jay agrees with me.
Diane, I think you know what our criteria is for a dark horse. It's usually Vegas making that line, and we've gone with 100-1 or higher odds for that. And Elk has gone with a player who is currently 22-1, which means Vegas thinks Vegas will back Elk's story. Cam Smith can definitely win it. Nobody would be surprised if he won it. He's already performed and won on the world's greatest tour. So Elk, I want to totally agree with everything you've said, but I just think you have him in the wrong category. He's definitely not a dark horse. I would put him in the top 15 of guys who have a chance to win this event for sure.
I have nothing more to say.